Have you ever wanted to make your own hot air balloon? Well, today I'm going to teach you how with my experiment, Flying Teabag Ghosts. Hi everyone, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we learn about all things space and science. So grab some tea bags because things are about to lift off. Today we are going to make our own hot air balloon with tea bags. What you need for this one is tea bags, but not every kind works. Twinings is a brand that works really well for this experiment. A bowl to put all of your extra tea in, some scissors to cut your tea bags open, markers to decorate our flying tea bag ghosts, and of course, a lighter. Parents and adults, because we are using fire, please exercise caution here. The first thing you want to do is open your tea bag, take out your tea, go ahead and unwrap that string there. And we are going to cut right along this line. It's important that you cut as straight as possible. So go ahead and cut a straight line right there. One, two, three. And now we're going to dump out our tea. You can save this for later if you like. Now what we want to do, give it a roll, open up that little cylinder there, and make sure it stands up. If it doesn't stand up very well, you may want to cut it so that your cut is a little bit more even. Perfect. And now we can decorate our tea bag. He's gonna be very scared because we're lighting him on fire. Oh no! And now here's the fun part. Set your tea bag up on a flat surface. Ready? Set. Go. Patience, 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 and watch our tea bag lift off. Go, 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 go. And that is our flying tea bag ghost. You'll notice that it incinerates really quickly. That's thanks to the fabric that tea bags are made out of. This is why the tea bags are perfect for this experiment, because they are so thin and they burn so quickly and they're light, so they can lift off. Our tea bag rose for the same reason that hot air balloons rise. When we lit it on fire, we heated up all of the air inside the tea bag. When air gets hot, it gets less dense, which makes it buoyant amidst regular air. And because our fabric is so thin and light, that allowed it to lift up the tea bag and make our tea bag ghosts fly. If you're having trouble making your tea bag ghosts fly, it's probably because of your tea bag. So you need a tea bag that folds out into a cylinder like this, but not all cylinders will work. Some brands have denser materials than others. And I'm telling you, Twinings tea bags work the best. Flying teabag ghosts. That was amazing. Thank you for making Flying Teabag Ghosts with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring book series for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.